So these are the guitar parts for Salvation's Tide. And this is, again, we're going to do this arrangement with just one electric guitar in it. So it's going to sound a little bit different from the recorded version, which has obviously more than one electric. And you'll be bouncing around on different like melodic figures throughout the song. So with that in mind, the song is not technically difficult. Like, none of the parts are actually hard to play. I think the challenge is really just going to be like thinking ahead and trying to remember what thing you're playing next, because it does change throughout the song. The choruses are the easiest. Those are just bar chords. The very first chorus is just sweeps. So, let the walls come down, in Jesus' name, let the lost be found, in Jesus' name. That, just one kind of sweep on the changes. And then every chorus after that will be more, just a little bit fuller strumming, probably quarter notes. So, let the walls come down, in Jesus' name. Like that. Everything else that you do is going to be melodic work. So let's talk through first the intro. You'll hear in the actual recording a piano go like do do do, and we are going to have a keyboard playing piano sounds that mimics that line, and then there's a little counter melody that I don't know if it's guitar. It might be a guitar. In any case, we're going to play it on the guitar. And it sounds like this, and it's probably going to be hard to put into context until you actually see it demonstrated with the recording, but this is what it sounds like alone. Like that. And I've actually, as I've been playing it, I've actually switched to the rhythm pickup. Just so you get that kind of like rounded, smooth, warm kind of sound from it. So you're not like cutting bright and like, because the piano is going to be kind of bright and you don't want to take away from the piano. The piano is definitely the main melody in that intro section and you don't want to like upstage the piano. You're just kind of complementing that. So that's the line. And like I said, you'll hear it better probably once we actually start demonstrating the song with the recording. You'll be able to put it into context instead of just random notes. Verse one is kind of strange. You're going to be tacit for everything but the third line, which is a little odd, but, there is no limit to your power. You'll be out for, you give us faith to move the mountains. You'll be out for, and then, we see the fires of revival. Darkness giving way to light. And after those two little accents, you'll be out again. So it's kind of an interesting, just kind of a different part for us. But just two little accents kind of during the third line of verse one, just to break it up a little bit, and reassure the audience that don't worry, we're going somewhere. We get to the first chorus. We've already talked about that, just strums and the changes. Verse two, is going to be very similar to your part in, My Life. That single note, dotted eighth note, ostinato kind of thing. And you're just going to play it on the G string on the 12th fret, so. So you're really just adding kind of texture there, and it's going to be throughout all of verse two. So the chords are going to change, everyone else is going to change what they're playing, but you're not. You're just going to hold that G. And in some of the chords, it's going to be this nice, solid foundational note, and some of the chords can be more of a color note, but that's okay. It's kind of that interesting, it's that tension that really makes that a cool part, because you're not playing much, you're just playing G over and over and over again. Yeah, it'll sound good in context. So when we get to the bridge, you're going to be playing a figure that's not actually represented in the recording at all. This is one of those instances where you really have to think role and not part. Because there's a lot of things going on in the bridge, a lot of, like, layers and layers of parts in the actual recording that we're not going to be reinterpreting exactly note for note how you're hearing it in the recording. This is a part that we're going to play, and it works well. It's going to accomplish the same thing to kind of create that build into that final chorus. So The bridge repeats three times, and the first two times you're out, and then the third time through, you're just kind of going to have your fingers on 12 and 13. And keep that going through the entire bridge until the very end, where you'll slide to the 20th fret. Like that, going into that final chorus. So, your life overflowing to wash our sin and shame away. Let the and then go right back into the chorus where you're playing bar chords as before. And then the outro is just the same feel as the chorus and the bridge. You're just kind of continuing that really high energy, full bar feel. So that's it. Like I said, the parts are not difficult. It's just a matter of being able to think ahead and remember, oh, what is it that I'm playing next? Because the melodic figures are all different in each part of the song. So I'm going to go ahead and cue up the song, and I'll play along, and I'm hoping that that kind of puts the parts into perspective a little bit. So in the intro, you're going to be out until you hear the piano. You're basically doing a call and response. Faith to move the mountains and the hope to dream again. This upcoming line, you're going to do those little accents. We see the fires of revival, the darkness giving way to light. The glory and then you're back of out. Grace advancing, let it burn up the night. Let it burn up the night. Single strums on the changes. breezed over the bar chord parts of the song, but there are a couple things that I think I probably should point out. The first chorus, where I said you just kind of changes, you'll feel this out in full band, but there's a possibility that it might just be too much, especially depending on, like, the tone of your guitar at the time. If it's too, like, crunchy and too muddy, it might just be too much for that part of the song. So if it doesn't seem like it's working, try adjusting your tone a little bit, and if it's still not working, try dropping out completely and see if that fixes the problem. So you might just be tacit that first chorus, and that's okay. It's totally fine. You don't always have to be playing. And then, in the second chorus, I think, when I first started playing, this is my natural tendency, and, I don't want to say that it's yours, but I know it's, a number of guitarists, the tendency is to play really fast. So, let the walls come down. Again, depending on your guitar tone and how this sounds in full band, the actual recording is only quarter notes. So, let the walls... Oh, sorry, not that note, though. Let the walls come down. And just because of the tone of the guitar and the recording, it works really well there. So depending on what you're doing and how it sounds full band with our instrumentation, you might need to play a little bit more busy, but I would suggest trying to start on quarter notes, because otherwise it has a tendency to get a little bit muddy, that part. I know for me, playing quarter notes is actually way harder than playing a more complicated strum pattern, because it forces me every single strum to really listen and lock in with the drummer. I find that I just have a tendency to either really rush or really fall behind when I'm just playing something simple like quarter notes. It's easier for me to subdivide and play like a much faster part. So it probably feels really boring, but there's actually a lot. Don't space out when you're playing it, because there's a lot to listen to and a lot to lock into. Finally, the outro. I feel like we can just play bar chord C, and that's going to sound great with everything else that's going on. It's going to kind of give it kind of a foundational... The notes aren't going to quite be exactly the same, but the notes between a C and an F2 over C are almost exactly the same. So I think it'll just kind of create a few like color notes and give the sound kind of a foundation. But if it doesn't work, if your music trainer is like, what's the wrong note in the outro? You can be like, hey, Jen told me to do something stupid, and I'm going to go ahead and change it, and you can play, go between C and F, the F bar chord. But I think it's going to sound better for us to stay constant and stay on that C. All that said, there's some in this song that I think you'll kind of feel out a little bit in full band, and if you're not sure about your part, ask Casey, and she'll help you kind of figure it out. But if you have any questions, always feel free to let me know. Thanks.